So that's what we are talking about, the derivation of the Pythagoras theorem. And I hope that from that video, you can able to see what you're talking about. You are referring to a square there. Remember, this square is the one which have been given, the two sides here, A and B. They have been given those two letters. Remember that the square contains the two sides that are equal. So we have the A and the B, and also the A and the B there. So we are saying to find the area of the outside triangle is the one that we are referring to as the A plus B square. Then, this one, when you open it, is the one that we are saying is the equivalent of what? Is the equivalent of the A plus B, is the one which is going to be equal to this one here. As you'll be able to know, this is what we agree. We have A plus B multiplied by A plus B. This one, when you open the bracket, it means that you take your A here, you multiply by A plus B. So this one, you multiply by the whole of that. And again, this B, you multiply by the whole of this. So it's going to be plus B, then you multiply by the whole of it. There. So that now, when you open the bracket, you're going to have A times A, give us A squared. Then A times A, that's going to be plus AB. Then this one is going to be plus another AB. And here you're going to have plus B squared. So if you collect the right term together, this one is going to be A squared, then plus 2AB, then plus B squared there. So that's what we are talking about, the concept which is concerning the issue of the outside triangle there. As you can see here, whereby we are talking about A plus B squared, then you're having here on the right hand side. Then again, we are saying to find the area that is inside, we have five of them, five figures. We have figure 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So four of them are triangle. You can see four in this area of this triangle there. Then one is a square, so C times C. That is going to give us the what? The C squared. So once you open the bracket, you're having C squared plus 2AB. At the end of the day, that's what we're saying, this one is going to be equivalent to the C squared again, then plus 2AB. So this one is the one, the area of the one which is inside, the inside. And then this one is the area of the outside. So the outside figure is that. And then now when you compare the two of them, you can be able to see this term is common on the other one. So what is going to happen here? So they are saying you cancel out. This one cancels out that. So when they cancel out, this is what you're going to have. This is going to cancel that one. And at the end of the day, that's like we said in the case of the static, this one is going to be A squared plus B squared is going to be equal to the C squared there. In this case, this is what we are referring as the Pythagoras theorem. So this is the theorem that we are talking about. So in the case of the derivation, during the exam, I will not be focusing on how to tell you to derive the Pythagoras theorem, but I want you to apply this theorem during your calculation. Hope that one is able to understand. I want us to continue with our video before we go to the next, before we go to the next slide.
From both the sides, we get C squared equal to A squared plus B squared. This is the Pythagoras theorem.
So in a nutshell, that's what I'm saying. That when you refer to that right angle, the triangle, this one is going to be our theorem that you're going to focus on it. So what I wanted to emphasize on this case is a situation. The situation whereby if I have this right angle triangle, then you can be able to derive other formulas to find the side of the triangle depending on which the side the examiner will be wanting you to be able to state. So this is what I mean. If I have my triangle here, yeah, that's the case number one. Then I have this one, this side that I'm given here. Let's say this one is A, and then this one is B. Then I told to find my C. This is my C. Then I'm told to find what is this side, which is the shorter side. Then I can have another triangle here. I've been given my B is here, and then here I'm not given, and then here I'm told to find the C, so I need to find that side. Then finally I can have this case. So you can see, this one I've been given, this is my A, then this is my B, and then I'm told to by that side. So one case that I'm confirming to you is that for you to apply this theorem, you have to make sure that the triangle that you're putting into consideration is a triangle which is a right-angled triangle. That is the first point that you need to be able to know it. Then from there, you state the Pythagoras theorem. So from this theorem, which is what? Which is A squared plus B squared is equals to C squared. That is the constant. So from this rule, we can be able to express our A squared is equal to C squared minus B squared. When you take B squared on the other side, so that is now from the Pythagoras theorem, you obtain that again. Then if I want you to get the B, then this is what I'll be saying, B squared is equals to, take now this one, take A to the other side, it's going to be C squared minus B, minus what, C squared minus B squared. That's what you're having is a Roman 3. Remember in this issue, always I'll not be wanting you to find the, or not be wanting me to find the side. So if I need the C, for me to get the C from this constant, it will be C will be equal to the square root of what? Of the A squared plus B squared. Because at every time, I'll be wanting you to find the side. So not be concentrating on the C, on the side square, but I'll be wanting you to find the side. So you have to take sure, you have to make sure that you take the square root in order to obtain the side. Same case to A. That's what you're going to have our A. It's going to be given by the square root of the C squared minus B squared. Then finally, for you to get my B, it's going to be the square root. It's going to be equals to what? It's going to be the square root of the C squared minus B squared. So this theorem, it arrives onto these three cases here. And these are the three cases that I'm saying. We are going to be using them in solving the problem and also in our day-to-day life situation. So that's the concept that I want to emphasize on it. So basically, this is all the derivation of the Pythagoras theorem, and it is the one that you're supposed to be able to use in your calculation. So let's see some examples that are going to take us to what we are going to apply here. So in my next slide, that's what I want you to be able to see. So the Pythagoras theorem, how does it state? That for a right-angled triangle, so all triangle must be right-angled. And you understand what you mean by a right-angle. If a triangle is not, if a triangle is not right-angle, then there is no way you can be able to focus onto it. You cannot be able to apply it if your side is not going to be, if your side is not going to be right-angled there. So your triangle must be the one which is going to be right-angled triangle. So the right-angled triangle